Welcome back to the Rex Reality channel. Today we have upped our quality. As you can see, we now have two cameras. I'm actually using my phone camera on one and my desktop web camera on the other one. So as the quality of the videos increases, hopefully so do the packages. We've got one here from AnaPro. I actually got this sent to a Samsung. Yeah, there's another Quest 2 head strap with a battery in it, so that's going to be very fun. So now, of course, how are we going to unbox this package? Well, we actually are going to use a fish. Caught this one myself from the River Thames, but we're going to unbox it with this. Clive, I'm sorry. I've known you for so long, Clive, but it's time. You're going to have to unbox this package for me, so thank you, Clive. Open the damn package! Thank you. Now you can swim! Oh, Clive! He's dead. All right, well, in Clive's memory, let's unbox his package. Here we go. All right, let's get this thing out. All the installation steps are on one page, which is nice. What's odd is that on this manual, it doesn't say AnaPro anywhere. It just says Q2 head strap, but it doesn't say the name of the company. Let's open this then. Ooh, here we go. Wow, that's actually a lot of padding. Wow, I'm very shocked at that, actually. Oh my God, there's so many parts to this. Compared to the last head strap I reviewed, which was the Q20 from, can't remember who. If you look at the padding on that thing, there was like no padding. This is like all padding. Already this back is looking very funky. Let me get a good shot on the overhead cam of that. That looks very nice. There's so much back padding on this. I'm assuming this is gonna be the battery bit. And of course you've got the cable which is gonna connect into the Quest 2 to charge it. This is the kind of wheel that I like on it. You can actually get some grip on that. Sometimes it's just like a perfect circle.
A perfect circle!
And that doesn't allow you to actually turn it that well. For my elongated head, it's gonna be very happy with this head strap. First impression is looking really good. I guess, yeah, we put it onto the Quest 2 now. Oh. Okay, it doesn't come with an interface, so I'm gonna have to borrow one. Pretty sure this has to go on afterwards, so I'll put that on after.
Now that I think about it, I don't know why I expected it to come with one, because you're always gonna have one anyway, so it doesn't really matter. And literally no other head strap I've gotten has come with one either, so. But I guess this is a good time to ask you to subscribe if you haven't already. Also, if you want to support me further, you can consider becoming a member, with the lowest tier being just £3 a month. You can unlock perks like seeing videos early, a special role in the Discord, and shoutouts in videos when I remember to. And also, I want to give a huge thanks to Wary Cryptical for being a member for 6 months now. Anyway, yeah, back to the video.
Anyway, let's put these on. Okay, this is odd. Normally, these things will wrap around the entire like speaker that holds it together. This one just seems to clip on the side. Very nice. And that's basically all that's needed, really. And of course we can connect this into there. This is such a weird head strap. You've got like two top straps here. Normally you would use this to like hook the top strap around onto it, but this one doesn't seem to be using that. Oh, I didn't even notice there's a light on that now. So this seems to be all the installation is. Normally there's so much more stuff that you have to do with this, but this is very straightforward. This is literally just snap the two things in. You don't even have to take the facial interface out. You can just leave it in, and there you're basically done. So I guess we just try this straight away. Okay, and here's the moment of truth. This is where it went wrong last time. The second I put the Q20 head strap from Easy SMX on, it all fell apart. Let's just try putting this on and hope that it doesn't. So let's just see if this is going to be good or not. The head strap straight away, there's so much padding. It feels like there's a lot going on here. Also, what's interesting is there's four lit up lights on the back of this. So I'm assuming, you'd think that would mean it was charged. I'll just see if in the headset it says it's charging. It does say it's charging. Okay, we're on 75% right now. I'm going to see if that goes up or down. This is the kind of head strap where you're going to have to mess around with it quite a lot, because there's so many different bits and bobs you can move around with it. There's like four different parts of this headset that you can move individually. So there's a lot of stuff you can change to see if you can get it to fit you correctly. Because there's so many different bits on it, it does feel like it's really hugging my head. Oh yeah! Okay, so we've just gone up to 76%, so it will charge over time. And that's interesting that it's arrived fully charged. Normally things like this come with fully dead, and I have to charge it up to 100%. This is another interesting thing. So with the Kiwi head strap, you can tilt the headset upwards while having it still be in your head, which is what I do for a lot of videos, and it makes it very convenient. So let's see if I can do that with this head strap. If I just lift it up, kind of. It's kind of like glasses, I'm just doing that. With the Kiwi one, you can just lift that up and the head strap stays where it is, but the headset lifts up. This one, I kind of feel like I'm lifting up the whole thing, so I have to, when I put it back down, I have to adjust it back again. This top strap as well, you can move around to be more at the back if you want it to be, or more at the front, depending on what you want. I think I'm going to use it a bit more in some games, and then I'll come back with my final thoughts at the end.
Alright, so right now my battery percentage is 82%. I'm going to play some Beat Saber for like an hour, and we'll see how that changes. And also, I'll let you know my full thoughts on the head strap in terms of comfortability and how I feel afterwards. But yeah, let's plug this in now. There we go. Boom, it's charging. Alright, so I'll see you guys in about 20 minutes. It's actually been about closer to 40 minutes, but as you can see, what's interesting is that it's actually gone down. My charge has gone down 3%. So it seems when you're playing a high intensity game that's going to take up a lot of your battery, your charge isn't going to actually increase, but it's just going to slow the decrease of it. Because trust me, the Quest 2 normally dies so much faster than 3% in 40 minutes. I actually did a live stream in Roblox that lasted about an hour. I started on 60% and it died by the end of the stream. That's how fast the Quest 2 dies. But as you can see, although it hasn't charged the headset, it has slowed the decrease of the percentage by a substantial amount. Onto comfortability, the comfortability of the head strap is actually very good. I really like all the support I'm getting from all angles on my head, and you can really customize how you want it to fit in your head because there's so many different angles that can move around so you can get it in the right spot. And also the headset does seem very firm to my head, which I really like. I don't like it wiggling around a lot like the PSVR did. But yeah, overall, I really recommend this head strap.
Massive thanks to Anapro for sending me this head strap. If you want to get it for yourself, you can check it out in the link in the description, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Goodbye. This is where it went wrong.